Ladies and gentlemen of the press, our political programs continue. This has been a meeting with members of the Bagosi community to review the state of affairs in our country after the last elections. Like people from other counties who have come here or whom we have visited, the Bagosi know their votes were stolen in the August and that Uhuru and Ruto have zero support in that county, those two counties. Looking at the landscape, we are agreed that hard times await our country in the days and years ahead, both in terms of the economy and protection of fundamental freedoms and liberties. We are agreed that only credible elections will bring stability to our country and help our economy grow. Sham elections will do the exact opposite, sinking us deeper into deeper poverty and taking us back to the era of authoritarian rules whose telltale signs are already around us. We have struggled and sacrificed for democracy and good governance before, and we are agreed that there must be no turning back. It is important that we stand with the and protect institutions that are standing up for the country in line with our constitution. Our Supreme Court in particular, and the judiciary in general, is one of those institutions that has tried to execute its mandate and spelled out in our constitution. They need protection. What we have seen, however, is Jubilee's vilification of institutions and individual officers that have done their duties while defending those who have failed. Jubilee has gone ahead to use the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission and the Directorate of Criminal Investigations to investigate the Registrar of the Supreme Court, Esa Nyaiyaki, whose crime was to deliver a scrutiny report of election results ordered by the court.